insolvency and bankruptcy code 2016. This is the year in which the bill has been passed, insolvency and bankruptcy code. So I already explained the meaning of insolvent. Who is said to be an insolvent? It could be a individual citizen or a partnership firm or simply a company, registered company, whose assets are much less than compared to the liabilities. Or someone who cannot afford to repay back the loan he borrowed is said to be insolvent. Someone who has been legally authorized as an insolvent is said to be called as bankrupt. So, and I already said the problem here in India when it comes to resolving the issue of insolvency, we are taking a huge amount of time, and too many laws exist in India in order to address the problem of insolvency and bankruptcy. Henceforth, the government of India has mooted a single solution and a single law, a one-stop solution to resolve the problems of insolvency and bankruptcy. Not only a one-stop solution, it is also when it comes to the basic aspect of time-bound resolution. Because what matters is not simply one-stop solution, what matters is also time-bound solution. You got it, my friends? So now, how is this particular insolvency and bankruptcy code is an improvement over these particular laws is simple. Okay, after the insolvency and bankruptcy code has come into picture, all these particular laws which are dealing with this particular aspect of insolvency, like the Bank Presidency Towns Insolvency Act, Sick Industries Companies Act, Limited Liability Partnership Act, Companies Act, okay, everything would be, okay, simply every aspect of insolvency which is part of it would be comprehended in the name of insolvency and bankruptcy code. Insolvency and bankruptcy code. So now the question is how to resolve this aspect of insolvency and bankruptcy. So the problem here in this case is here is a company. Okay, I'm just explaining how things work, then you could understand what are the major important aspects of insolvency and bankruptcy code. Now here is a company. Like you have the assets of a company and liabilities of a company. And this company has borrowed huge amount of money from its lenders. Generally what we call creditors of the company. Creditors. And who is the debtor in this case? The company itself is the debtor. So the company, in this case Lanco Infratech, is the debtor, the one who borrowed money, and the creditors. Now at times when a company experiences this basic problem of insolvency or bankruptcy, as of now, after insolvency bankruptcy code came into being, once a company has been bankrupted, you have two options. Either the creditors or the debtors can move to an adjudicating authority. To an adjudicating authority who takes care of this issue of resolving the issue of insolvency and bankruptcy. You can approach an adjudicating authority. When it comes to a company, that particular agency that is going to resolve the issue is National Company Law Tribunal. If it is with respect to an individual or a partnership firm, you need to approach a debt recovery tribunal. So these are the two adjudicating authorities when it comes to resolving the aspect of insolvency and bankruptcy. Okay, so if it is a company, you need to approach a National Company Law Tribunal. You got it, my friends? So either a creditor can approach saying that I have lent the money to this person, but this company is not performing, neither repaying interest nor repaying principal. Please do something to get my money back. So creditor can approach, or the debtor, the company itself can approach and say, hey, look, I am the one who has borrowed money. I have invested in the business, but my business is not performing better. And henceforth, I am not able to repay the loan, but my asset quality is deteriorating. Liabilities are increasing. I am about to be insolvent or I am about to be bankrupted. So please help me getting out of this particular crisis. Any of these two players can approach the respective adjudicating authorities. So in case of a company, you need to approach a National Company Law Tribunal. In case if you are an individual or it's a partnership firm, you need to approach a debt recovery tribunal. And once you go and submit the application, they have to they have to either accept or reject in a span of 14 days. They have to either accept or reject the application. You get it, my friends? So they have to at least decide whether they are going to go ahead with resolving this basic aspect of insolvency or bankruptcy. 14 days may they should decide. And I am repeating, UPSC would not ask such kind of questions. How many days it takes for NCLRT, okay, DRT to accept or reject? 14 days, 13 days, 13.9 days, 14.01 days. Such kind of questions would not be asked. Just as a matter of information, okay, I'm passing it on, but just don't end up mugging it just because I was discussing about it. Just have a glimpse of, or simply have an overall idea of what is the basic purpose and try to appreciate if it seems to be good what the government is doing. Okay, or you can follow PD, isn't it? The one who tweets on behalf of Rahul Gandhi, and you can also end up criticizing, it's up to you. But you know PD, the name of the dog of Rahul. Isn't it? So previously people started saying, who is tweeting on behalf of you? So he ended up saying, it is my PD. He has taken a picture of that particular dog and he also posted in Twitter. It is my PD who is tweeting on behalf of me. Okay, so that's an altogether different story. We'll discuss later point of time. Coming back. So the only purpose I am discussing is you should be able to understand. Okay, the what purpose does it serve? 14 days may they would, okay, they should either say, yes, I am going to accept your application. I'll move it forward and henceforth I'll resolve the issue. Or else you can say, okay, I'm not someone who has that particular, okay, I mean, I think I'm not able to do it. Something you should either accept or reject in a span of 14 days. Once you have accepted, the process is that the entire process of, okay, resolution has to be completed in a span of 180 days. Only in certain exceptional cases, it has to go, okay, an extra, they might take some extra 90 days. Some extra 90 days. And what do you think these people would be doing in between? Okay, in between. Beach may, what do you think these particular fellows would be doing? They would simply appoint someone called insolvency professionals. Insolvency professionals. Like if they are someone like these chartered accountants or company secretaries, like you can also, I mean, someone who are having an expertise in resolving such kind of problems, insolvency and bankruptcy. So what do these insolvency professionals? So these are the insolvency, these are certain professionals or certain kind of people who has this expertise in trying to ensure recovery or trying to ensure or resolve such kind of problems of a company. So what they do? They look after various opportunities in order to ensure the company would be recovering. Okay, so they might either approach a big investor, or might ask him to purchase some bad debt and take it, convert into equity, or they can ask the creditors of the company. Why don't you end up becoming a net owners of the company, shareholders of the company? Why don't you accept for writing off some amount of debt? Please write off some amount of debt. Let's say in this case to this Lanco Infratech. Let's say this fellow or some private bank or ICICI, some state bank, okay, whatever, the PSU bank, has accumulated some amount of money. So they could come up with a comprehensive solution or a compromising solution. USBA, okay, why don't you accept your loan as a equity or an investment? You get it, my friends? Or else ask some big investor or someone who is into power construction or power production. Let's say some big company who is into power production to take over this company or go for merger and acquisition of this company. Do something. Okay, explore any chance that is feasible to ensure the company would sustain. The company would sustain. The worst thing that can happen for this company is liquidation. And that too only when more, okay, creditors and more debtors, okay, I mean the, either the debtor and more percentage of the creditors accept it, only in such case, okay, they have to go for this particular plan that has been extended by insolvency professionals. You got it, my friends? So, and the regulating agency, who take care of entire process is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. So this is one who would be regulating this particular aspect. Once the issue has been taken over and trying to resolve the issue of this particular company's insolvency and bankruptcy, this body would be the one who would be regulating even when it comes to the practice of these insolvency professionals. Like Institute of Chartered Accountant of India, isn't it? Okay, similarly, this body is the one who would be regulating the practice and everything would be taken care of by this particular regulating agency. So what do these professionals end up doing? They explore all kind of possible chances to help in revival of this company. So they can take the balance sheet of the company or they can approach some big investor in power production business, ask him, sir, would you like to take this company for 50%, 30%, thoda dijiye, please do purchase it. Or you just simply acquire this company. or simply you become a net investor because you have invested huge amount of money or you have lent huge amount of money, instead of expecting money paid back in the form of principal interest, why don't you end up becoming a partner of the company? So they do most, I mean everything possible on it to ensure the company would be revived. And that particular plan put forward by these insolvency professionals when it comes to resolving the address, okay, resolving the issue of the company would be accepted only if majority of the stakeholders, okay, in the creditor group or this group would accept it. Only in such case, the plan put forward by these particular agencies, NCLT or DRT. So after 180 or 270 days, they would be putting some plan forward. Hey, look, this is your problem. Okay, you're not able to repay its debt. Your debt, your assets are very low. So I have come up with a solution. How come some amount of debt would not be repaid? Let's say creditor approached, like an SB who lent money to this fellow approached this NCLT. So the NCLT might be saying, hey look, 20% of the loan he cannot repay. For the rest of the 80%, I would suggest you take over the company. Or I would suggest this company would be taken by Ratan Tata and he would be paying the money, that money would be paid to you. Okay, any such solution that has been put forth by these two agencies would go ahead when it comes to implementation only if it has a consent of majority of the stakeholders. Majority of stakeholders of the creditors or the one who has approached the NCLT or DRT. In case if you don't come up with any particular solution within this span of stipulated time and there was no common acceptable feasible solution between all these stakeholders, the ultimate thing that could happen is simply liquidation of the company. But everything is going to happen by one particular law, that is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, within a stipulated time by one particular agency, either NCLT or DRT, under one particular act called Insolvency and Bankruptcy. That's it. This small improvement, this particular mooting of this law itself has increased India's ranking somewhere from 130 to 100 when it comes to ease of doing business. Because what matters for an investor is not simply easy entry and a level playing field. Okay, easy exit also matters, because every time you invest in a business, it is not guaranteed you would be making profits. So if you think that you're someone who cannot sustain the business, there has to be easy exit and also again re-entry. You get it, my friends? So that is what is IBC. And this Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code has been reality in 2016, and in 2017 there is an amendment to it. There is an amendment to this IBC. What was that amendment all about? When it comes to participation in the resolution process, the latest amendment says, someone who has been declared as a willful defaulter, someone who has been declared as a willful defaulter or a promoter of a company, which has already been announced as an insolvent or bankrupt. You got it, my friends? Following. So the amendment, the recent amendment of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code has exempted certain class of people or certain class of investors to participate when it comes to the aspect of resolving this such kind of aspects of insolvency and bankruptcy code. You got it, my friends? Okay. Or simply the other people are simply directors of companies. Some directors of certain companies whose director DIN has been cancelled. Directors of certain companies who have been not authorized. So the recent amendment is that these are the category of people. I mean, the one who has been declared as willful defaulter could not participate when it comes to the process of resolving. See, simply when I come to process of resolving, simple. Hearing this, a Lanco Infratech company. Not sustaining. Not able to sustain. Henceforth, I have put forward a plan. The company assets are worth some 50,000 crores, but the liabilities are worth some 60,000 crores. Henceforth, the company has been bankrupted. Now I have come up with a comprehensive solution wherein my all stakeholders accepted. What is the stakeholders accepted is that liability is 60,000. But someone who is able to give me some 45,000 crores as of now, I will give this company to this people. Just imagine. Okay, someone who could purchase this company at this particular rate, I am ready to surrender this company worth certain amount of money. So in such case, who will be that people who need to participate, who are allowed to participate in the process of resolving? Okay, recently the amendment says those people who have been announced as willful defaulters in previous days could not participate when it comes to the process of resolving such kind of companies. are those people who have been the directors of those companies who have been involved in fraud and whose DIN has been cancelled, isn't it? Recently the government has ended up simply disqualifying too many directors of the company, shell companies, in the process of overcoming this basic problem of money laundering, isn't it? And simply the promoters of the companies who have already been insolvent and bankrupt. This was the latest amendment when it comes to Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2017. Following, this is all about Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code.